Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do this time series problem. It essentially is giving you a list of different time series or stochastic processes, and it's asking you to determine which of them, if any, are stationary. So this question comes from the Brockwell and Davis time series book, where they define stationarity as weak stationarity. So there's technically a definition of weak stationarity and also strict stationarity, but for time series, usually we want to just meet the definition of weak stationarity. So weak stationarity is a less strict stationarity assumption, and it's based on two parts. So it's based on essentially looking for stationarity in the first moment and the second moment of your stochastic process. So this definition is also from the Brockwell and Davis book, and it says that a time series is weakly stationary if the first moment does not depend on time t. In other words, that the mean is constant for your time series, and that the autocovariance function for t and t plus a lag h is independent of time t. So this is saying that the autocovariance of xt is also constant. So essentially, if you're checking for stationarity of a time series, what you want to do is get the expected value of your time series and make sure it's a constant and doesn't depend on the time, and also check for the autocovariance between time t and time t plus any lag and make sure that also is constant. And if your first two moments are constant, then your time series meets the definition of weak stationarity. So for this video, I'm going to do the first two problems. I'm going to do A and B. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to start with problem A, and for every problem I'm going to first check that the mean is constant and then check the autocovariance function. So the expected value, or the mean, of x of t is just going to be plugging in the expected value of the right hand side, which is a plus b times zt, and we're given in the problem that zt's are distributed with mean 0 and variance sigma squared. We're going to use that information later, plus c times zt minus 2. And we're also given that a, b, and c are constants. So the expected value of a constant is just a constant. So we can simplify this as the expected value of a is just a plus b times the expected value of zt plus c times the expected value of zt minus 2. We're given in the problem that the expected values of the zt's are 0. So this is going to be equal to a plus 0, or b times 0, which is just 0, plus c times 0, which is just 0. So the expected value of x of t is equal to a, which does not depend on t, and so we've met the first assumption for weak stationarity. So our mean is stationary, and now we have to check the second moment, or the autocovariance function of a, to make sure that it is weakly stationary. So for the second part, I'm going to check the covariance between xt plus h, so xt plus a lag h, and just regular xt. And again, I'm going to plug in xt, the right-hand side, and xt plus h, the right-hand side, for this part. So that's going to be equal to the autocovariance between a plus b times zt plus h plus c times zt minus 2 plus h, and x of t, which is just a plus b times zt plus c times zt minus 2. Then for the next step, I'm essentially going to expand this single covariance function into the covariance between each part of the expressions by comparing each part of the first expression to each part of the second expression. So I'm going to start with the first part, which is a. So the covariance between a and a, this first part, second part, and third part, is going to be 0 because a is just a constant. So the covariance between any constant and any other constant or random variable is just going to be 0. So I'm finished with comparing a. For this second part of the expression, again, the covariance between a random variable and a constant is just 0, so that's 0. Then the covariance between this first part, bzt plus h, and this second part, bzt, is equal to the covariance between bzt plus h and bzt, plus The covariance between this second part and the last part is going to be equal to the covariance between b zt plus h and c times zt minus 2. So I've essentially just expanded the expression using covariance properties, and I'm going to do the same thing for the last part. So the covariance between this third part and a constant is just 0. Then the covariance between this part and BCT is going to be expanded out, and I'm going to do the same thing with the last two parts of the expressions. So I'm going to have, this is my expanded covariance function. And now as a final part, I have to determine the stationarity of this autocovariance function for any lag h. So when h is 0, we're going to have the covariance between BZT plus 0 and BCT. So that's just going to be b squared and the covariance between two random variables ZT. So the covariance between ZT and ZT will just give you the variance of ZT, which we're given is sigma squared. So that's what the expression will be for this first part. Here, ZT plus 0 and ZT minus 2, the covariance between that will be 0. The same thing will happen for this expression, that will just be 0. And then here, if we plug in 0, we'll get that this is equal to C squared times the variance of ZT minus 2, which is just sigma squared. So when we have that the lag H is equal to 0, this will be our autocovariance function. Then we essentially have to worry about when these two values in the middle will not be 0. And we can see that that's going to be when H is equal to plus or minus 2. So when H is equal to minus 2, that's going to give us the covariance between BC and Z minus 2, and Z minus 2, which is the variance of ZT minus 2, or sigma squared. So the same thing is going to happen when we have H is equal to positive 2. If we plug in positive 2 for H here, we're going to get ZT and ZT. Then the covariance between C times ZT and B times ZT is going to be BC and the variance of ZT, which is sigma squared. Then the autocovariance is going to be 0 for any other lags. So the autocovariance is going to be 0 for any other lag that's not 0 or plus or minus 2. So this is our final autocovariance function expression. And as we can see, for any lag h, the autocovariance expression does not depend on time t. So we have that the first moment, or the mean of the stochastic process, does not depend on time t, and we have that the autocovariance function does not depend on time t for any lag h. Thus, for problem A, we do have weak stationarity. And I think I'm going to end the video here instead of doing part B because it's already getting a little bit long. Maybe in the future I'll make a second video where I can do some of these other problems. But for now, I'll end the video here, and thank you guys for watching.